introductory sentence. You have been buried with Christ in baptism, in which you have also been raised with him through faith in the working of God, who raised him from the dead. Colossians chapter 2, verse 12. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
The collect of purity.
Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Gloria in excelsis. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth.
Lord God, heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High. Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father.
Amen. Collect of the Day. Lord God our Father, through our Savior Jesus Christ, you have assured mankind of eternal life, and in baptism have made us one with him. Deliver us from the death of sin and raise us to new life in your love. In the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, by the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Today's reading is taken from Genesis chapter 21, verses 8 to 21. So the child grew and was weaned, and Abraham made a great feast on the same day that Isaac was weaned. And Sarah saw the son of Hagar, the Egyptian, whom she had borne to Abraham, scoffing. Therefore she said to Abraham, "Cast out this born woman and her son, for the son of this born woman shall not be heir with my son, namely with Isaac." And the matter was very displeasing in Abraham's sight because of his son. But God said to Abraham, "Do not let it be displeasing in your sight because of the lad, or because of your born woman. Whatever Sarah has said to you, listen to her voice, for in Isaac your seed shall be called. Yet I will also make a nation of the son of the born woman, because he is your seed." So Abraham rose early in the morning and took bread and a skin of water, and putting it on her shoulder, he gave it and the boy to Hagar, and sent her away. Then she departed and wandered in the wilderness of Beersheba. And the water in the skin was used up, and she placed the boy under one of the shrubs. Then she went and sat down across from him at a distance of about a bow shot. For she said to herself, "Let me not see the death of the boy." So she sat opposite him and lifted her voice and wept. And God heard the voice of the lad. Then the angel of God called to Hagar out of heaven and said to her, "What ails you, Hagar? Fear not, for God has heard the voice of the lad where he is. Arise, lift up the lad and hold him with your hand, for I will make him a great nation." Then God opened her eyes, and she saw a well of water. And she went and filled the skin with water and gave the lad a drink. So God was with the lad, and he grew and dwelt in the wilderness and became an archer. He dwelt in the wilderness of Paran, and his mother took a wife for him from the land of Egypt. This is the word of God. Amen.
Psalm for today is taken from chapter 86, verses 1 until 10, and continue from 16 till the end. We shall read responsively. I shall read the odd verses, and the congregation shall read the even verses, and the last verses shall be read all together. Hear me, Lord, and answer me, for I am poor and needy.
Guard my life, for I am faithful to you. Save your servant who trusts in you. You are my God.
Have mercy on me, Lord, for I call to you all day long.
Bring joy to your servant, Lord, for I put my trust in you.
You, Lord, are forgiving and good, abounding in love to all who call you.
Hear my prayer, Lord. Listen to my cry for mercy.
When I am in distress, I call to you because you answer me.
Among the gods, there is none like you, Lord. No deeds can compare with yours.
All the nations you have made will come and worship before you, Lord. They will bring glory to your name.
For you are great and do marvelous deeds. You alone are God.
Turn to me and have mercy on me. Show your strength in behalf of your servant. Save me because I serve you, just as my mother did altogether.
Give me a sign of your goodness that my enemies may see it and be put to shame. For you, Lord, have helped me and comforted me.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
The New Testament reading for today is taken from Romans chapter 6, verses 1 to 11. What shall we say then? Shall we go shining so that grace may increase? By no means. We are those who have died to sin. How can we live in it any longer? Or don't you know that all of us who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were therefore buried with him through baptism into death, in order that, just as Christ was raised from the dead through the glory of the Father, we too may live a new life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we will certainly also be united with him in a resurrection like his. For we know that our old self was crucified with him, so that the body ruled by sin might be done away with, that we should no longer be slaves to sin, because anyone who has died has been set free from sin. Now, if we died with Christ, we believe that we will also live with him. For we know that since Christ was raised from the dead, he cannot die again. Death no longer has mastery over him. The death he died to sin once for all. But the life he lives to God. In the same way, count yourself dead to sin, but alive in God in Christ Jesus. This is the word of the Lord.
Today is second Sunday after Trinity, the continuation of our Gospel reading, the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. Matthew chapter 10, verses 24 to 39. Glory to Christ our Savior. The student is not above the teacher, nor a servant above his master. It is enough for students to be like their teacher, and servants like their master. If the head of the house has been called Zerubbabel, how much more the members of his household? So do not be afraid of them, for there is nothing concealed that will not be disclosed, or hidden that will not be made known. What I tell you in the dark, speak in the daylight. What is whispered in your ear, proclaim from the roofs. Do not be afraid of those who kill the body but cannot kill the soul. Rather, be afraid of the one who can destroy both soul and body in hell. Are not sparrows sold for a penny? Yet not one of them will fall to the ground outside our Father's care. And even the very hairs of your head are all numbered. So don't be afraid. You are worth more than many sparrows. Whoever acknowledges me before others, I will also acknowledge before my Father in heaven. But whoever disowns me before others, I will disown before my Father in heaven. Do not suppose that I have come to bring peace to the earth. I did not come to bring peace, but a sword, for I have come to turn a man against his father, a daughter against her mother, a daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law. A man's enemy will be the members of his own household. Anyone who loves their father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. Anyone who loves their son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. Whoever does not take up their cross and follow me is not worthy of me. Whoever finds their life will lose it, and whoever loses their life for my sake will find it. This is the gospel of Christ. Praise to Christ our Lord. Today is Father's Day. Most of the men I know are doing the best they can. They work hard to provide for their families, both financially and spiritually. In fact, I think they are worthy of a good old-fashioned pat on the back. I think we should have a special day for them and tell them how much we appreciate them. We could buy them a tie or something and tell them we love them. I know we could do it 6 weeks after Mother's Day, and we could call it Father's Day. Maybe this holiday isn't that difficult after all. Let us wish every father a blessed and a happy Father's Day. Lectionary reading and preaching this second Sunday after Trinity. Let us turn our Bibles to the passage in Romans chapter 6 verse 4. We were therefore buried with him through baptism into death, in order that just as Christ was raised from the dead through the glory of the Father, we too may live a new life. This verse gives us majestic picture of our salvation, the picture of the glorious events of Christ's death and resurrection. The word baptism here does not refer to water baptism, but to our spiritual baptism, which took place at the time we were saved. According to the Apostle Paul, when we were saved, we became spiritually identified with Christ in his death, his burial, and his resurrection. It was then we died to our old life of sin, and we were spiritually resurrected to the new life we now have in Christ. This must cause us now to live a new life, to actually live out in our daily living the results of our salvation from sin. Now, what does it mean to live a new life? I would like to suggest that it means three things. Firstly, live a new life means to live a resurrected life. In verse 4, the phrase live a new life is actually connected to the idea of Christ's resurrected body. As Christ was raised up from the dead, we also should live a new life. The resurrection of Christ was not the same as the earlier miraculous resurrection of people like Lazarus and the son of the widow of Nain. In these earlier resurrections, those who came back to life had the same corruptible bodies they had before they died. But the resurrected body of Jesus was new, different, and superior in quality compared to his former pre-resurrection body. It was free from all the itches, pains, and physical ailments of the former body. It was created for life in heaven, not on earth. In the same way, therefore, our life after salvation should be new, different, and superior in quality to our former life. It should be free from all the sinful and corrupt habits of the former life. It lives for heavenly things and not for earthly things anymore. This is what we mean by the resurrected life. As 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 17 says, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. Dearly beloved, is our life different now from what it was before we were saved? Do we still love the things that we loved before? If we are living the new life, our values in life will be different. We will be more concerned with the things of God than the things of the world, and with the things that are eternal rather than with things that are temporal, and with things that are above rather than with things that are on the earth. Augustine, who was converted as an adult, was once approached by the woman who had been his mistress. He turned and walked away quickly, but she called out after him, "Augustine, it's me, it's me." Quickening his pace, this new believer, Augustine, called back over his shoulder, "Yes, I know, but it is no longer me. I am not what I was. I am a new creation." Augustine became a new man in Jesus Christ. Let us now go on to see the second thing that is meant by the term live in a new life. Verse 6 and 7. For we know that our old self was crucified with him, so that the body ruled by sin might be done away with, that we should no longer be slaves to sin, because anyone who has died has been set free from sin. This verse shows us our identification with Christ breaks the power of sin in our lives. To live a new life, therefore, means to live a released life. The picture Paul uses is that of slaves who are liberated from their bondage. A slave is a person who is owned by another without any rights at all, like any other forms of personal property. He was to be used and disposed of in whatever way the owner may wish. Before Christ saved us, we were all slaves to sin. Sin dominated our thoughts and actions like a hard and cruel taskmaster, and we were helpless under its control. We served sin and suffered all the unpleasant effects that came with it. Hatred, bitterness, deceit, strife, jealousy, rebellion, pride, and lust. But all that has now changed through the death and resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. We are liberated, delivered, and set free from its power. Although sin may still be present in our lives, its power over us is broken. We do not have to serve sin anymore. To live a new life, therefore, means that we are to live a life that is released from the power of sin. Only those who are truly saved will be able to do this. Those who are not saved cannot succeed to live a released life, no matter how hard they may try, because they are still under the power of sin. Perhaps there may even be someone right here who is like that. Examine ourselves and ask this question: do I still find myself helpless under the power of sin? Is my life still controlled by sin? And I can't seem to live a new life no matter how hard I have tried. If our answer to both of these questions is yes, then we must not delay any longer to come to Jesus Christ and ask Him to come into our life. Please make sure of our salvation before this day ends. Let us now go on to look at the third thing that live a new life means. Verse 11. In the same way, count ourselves dead to sin but alive to God in Jesus Christ. We who are saved are now alive to God. That adds a meaning to the concept of living a new life. It is a revived life. We were formerly spiritually dead, lifeless, and alienated from the life of God. But now, through Jesus Christ, we are made alive to God. We now have a new principle of life that energizes us and gives us the special ability to relate to God and to respond to God. We all know that things are dead, have no ability to hear and respond. We may shout at them, scream at them, pinch them, shake them, and still not get the slightest response from them. Jesus once said this to the spiritually dead Pharisees. Why is my language not clear to you? Because you are unable to hear what I say. Whoever belongs to God hears what God says. The reason you do not hear is that you do not belong to God. John chapter 8, verses 43 and 47. Those who are not alive to God have no ability to listen to God's word. Even though there may be nothing wrong with their ears, God's words has no effect on their lives. They will often find it quite meaningless and hard to understand. But a person who is alive to God listens to Him. When He speaks through His word, He is ready to do His bidding. He takes God's word seriously. He trembles at God's word and is moved and convicted with it. And then he responds to that word with prayer, trust, and obedience. He is not just a hearer of the word, but also a doer of the word. He is like the good ground in the parable of the sower of Matthew chapter 13. Who hears the word and understands it? This is the one who produces a crop yielding 160 and 30 times what was sown. Dearly beloved, the question we have to ask this time is, am I alive to God? Do I listen to Him when He speaks to me through His word? Do I respond to Him readily? Or am I more like a dead person who does not seem to listen or respond at all? Let us not live as if we are dead, but alive to God if we are to live a new life. As we come to the end of this sharing, 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 17 reminds us, if any man is in Christ, he is a new creature. That speaks of transformation, like a caterpillar that goes into a cocoon and dies, and the life that comes forth from that is totally different. May God give us a new life. Happy Father's Day. Let us pray. Our Lord, so much could be said, and I pray that your Holy Spirit would make these things clear to all our hearts. We thank you that you have saved us and made us into new creations. And we are not what we ought to be, and we are not what we want to be, and we are not what we are going to be, and neither are we what we used to be. Father God, how glorious a gift is this, to have all things pass away and be made new, to be granted love, joy, peace, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, self-control, the fruit of the Spirit, to be given the knowledge of the truth, the power of the Spirit. Oh Father, how rich we are. We thank you for the miracle of transformation that accompanies justification. We pray that this sanctification, this transformation, which was begun at the moment of our faith, will progress and continue along the path toward Christ-likeness, ever increasing until Jesus we see. May God help and bless all the Father who are struggling and who need you. We pray, God, grant us a new life in Christ Jesus. We pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen.
The Nicene Creed.
We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, one in being with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven by the power of the Holy Spirit. He was born of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered, died, and was buried. On the third day he rose again in fulfillment of the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end.
We believe in the Holy Spirit,
the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
I will sing for my God. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for your blessings that we can continue to learn your words even during this challenging time through this online Sunday service. No matter what we face today, with your grace, we will be able to endure, overcome, and prevail. Let us pray for the church and for the world. Let us thank God for his goodness. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who promised through your Son Jesus Christ to hear us when we pray in faith, we give thanks for the churches throughout the world, remembering today Old Saint Church KL, Our Savior Church Salat South, Saint Gabriel Church KL, SGC Life Sanctuary PJ, Emmanuel Anglican Church Cheras, Damai Perdana Anglican Center, and Holy Trinity Church Bukit Bintang KL. We also pray for our own Christchurch Melaka, led by Red Reverend Dr. Jason Selvaraj and assisted by Evangelist Paul Khoo. Strengthen your church to carry forward the work of Christ, that we and all who confess in your name may unite in your truth, live together in your love, and reveal your glory to the world. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. In our own nation, Malaysia, we pray for exceptional wisdom to all international, national, and local political leaders. Guide them as they make important decisions for the nation and for the people. Provide them the ability to communicate clearly and compassionately to the people. We also pray for our clergy, deaconesses, lay leaders, lay pastors, and evangelists. We pray that they will hold on to the joy of the Lord in spite of everything they have to deal in the ministry. Give them wisdom of the Lord in their daily work during this challenging time. May their mind and spirit be refreshed, restored, recharged, and renewed to serve the God Almighty. We pray for the nation of the world, especially for Philippines. We pray for more Filipino churches to raise up and send out missionaries committed to worldwide evangelism. We also pray for honesty, justice, and fairness to replace corruption and greed in the government. We pray for the church to stand firm on biblical truths and to be unified with one another. We also pray for Brunei. We pray for salvation of the people, that they would lead their nation to righteousness. Pray for creative and bold witnesses to the majority in the country. We pray for spiritual maturity and biblical training for layperson who leading the underground church. As we are celebrating Father's Day today, we want to pray for all the dad in the world. Father, we ask that you guide them to be a good role model and loving to their children and family. We also want to give thanks to all who are celebrating their birthday this week. We pray for Raymond Prakash, Nageswaran, Linda Andrew, and Joash Ethan Selvaraj. May God's loving presence in their life be felt strongly on their birthday and every day. Give grace to us, our families and friends, and to all our neighbors in Christ, that we may serve Him in one another and love as He loves us. We also want to pray for God's healing grace, especially for Rebecca's dad, Grace Jackson, Annie Cherian, Pushpa Gunaraj, Esther Das, Jesse Das, and the elderly of our congregation. May God heal all of them. Comfort and heal those who suffer in body, mind, and spirit. Give them courage and hope in their troubles and bring them joy of your salvation. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We commemorate the departed, remembering the passing of Ebenezer, Auntie Jesse's and Esther's brother. May his soul rest in peace, and may God give his family all the strength and comfort during this difficult time. We commend all men to your unfailing love, that in them your will may be fulfilled. And we rejoice at the faithful witness of your saints in every age, praying that we may share with them in your eternal kingdom. Lord, in your mercy, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ. Amen.
Hear what St. Paul says. This saying is true and worthy of full acceptance, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Let us therefore confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in love and peace with all men. The confession. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father,
we have sinned against you and against our fellow men, in thought and word and deed, in the evil we have done and in the good we have not done, through ignorance, through weakness, through our own deliberate fall. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon us. Pardon and deliver us from all our sins. Confirm and strengthen us in all goodness and keep us in life eternal. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord's Prayer, as our Savior taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Post communion sentence. God save us not because of deeds done by us in righteousness, but in virtue of his own mercy by the washing of regeneration and renewal in the Holy Spirit. Titus chapter 3 verse 5. Post communion prayer. Loving Father, we thank you for feeding us at the supper of your Son. Sustain us with your Spirit, that we may serve you here on earth until our joy is complete in heaven, and we share in the eternal banquet with Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. May the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all. Amen. Go in peace and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you. I sent home from school one day with a shiner on my eye. Fighting was against the rules and it didn't matter why. When Dad got home, I told that story just like
a father is neither a sun nor a moon that lights up the whole sky. He is a candle in the shadows of the night, shining brightly to those who surround him. Blessed Father's Day!
Shalom, selamat hari apai, ngagai balapai, awak kita bujur dalam penghidup, awak kita meruan dalam penghidup, agai kita sepilih.
Pak, terima kasih, saya ingin mau jaga kau ini, bagu-bagu, mau ngajar kau ini, dan bimbing kau ini, di orang di bawah tu. Walaupun dengan modi, tapi dengan tetap ogi dan otin, dan bimbing kau ini. Selamat untuk sama, terus suak-suak sama di dalam dunia ini.
Andai sesarap ku mahadikabu kasangkat, ailaan ku ngabito kau, kau nda marong anu tada baino, ika mo yan di hari bapa. Na antakan hari bapa diti, ku mahadikabu nga apa-apa siti menganu aku kasibatan, dopa bar selamat hari bapa. Semoga lebih abarkatan di kinoringan om andai kesehatan, Tuhan memberkati. Om ya paku, biarpun noso siti, umpang aku mengucap selamat hari bapa. Pun si kau togumu selama di kau kibar dalam hidupku. Ikau apaku so gigi so.
Ba, 父亲节快乐. 因为你, 教了我, 很多事情, 不管是好或者是坏的. 因为你, 我才可以成为, 现在的我. 父亲节快乐.
Hello, ich werde sagen,
zuerst
nicht vor. Aber danke, Papa, für alles, was es ist. Und der Vater in der Kirche des Malaka. Und alle Vater der Welt. Alles Gute, so, was es hat. Wer lebe dich?
Father, say to all the fathers in our church. May God bless you today and always. We love you all so much. Bye.
Happy Father's Day to all the fathers in our church. May God bless you abundantly. Happy Father's Day.
Happy Father's Day. We love you.
My heart went. My heart just got stuck between these loops.
Father's Day, Father's Day, Happy Father's Day. Here's a gift.
Hi, good morning. This is an important announcement concerning our annual general meeting, the reports and the accounts. So please listen carefully to the different circumstances and settings now. So we have the diocesan bishop together with the other bishops and archdeacons and the standing committee and decided on the following protocol to observe for the AGM. Now, please note that firstly, that our AGM will be held on 9th August, Sunday, 9th August at 11 a.m. We'll start with a simple, short Holy Communion service at 10. And because we can only gather in a setting of worship, so that's the reason why we're having the Holy Communion service followed by the AGM. Now, only 30 people are allowed into the church building proper for the AGM, and that will be the key persons who are involved directly. That is the verger, the caretaker, you know, the choir, lay leaders, etc. And also the secretary and the treasurer and the new treasurer. So all this they have to be in, and the rest can follow the AGM via Zoom or WhatsApp or any other electronic means. we can follow. Alright? Now, that's one about the date and the time of the AGM. Now, as the vicar of the parish, I'll be the chief returning officer, as I'll take charge of the election, etc. Right? Now, secondly, the lateral list must be shown to the members, but we have shown it, we have displayed it, and also the corrected and amended one also has been displayed. So there's no need of us to display that again. But the post for of PCC for election, the 8 members, as well as the people's warden and the nomination form, must be sent out to all lateral members. Now, to those of you who are on the WhatsApp chat group, we will send it to you via PDF file. So please do the needful to download the reports as well as the accounts. Now, to those who are not on the WhatsApp group, please note that we will send it by post. Now, as you know, our Post Malaysia is a very efficient organization. So we're not sure when you will receive it, but we are trying to send it as early as possible by next week. Once we get the reports are ready, now we're just waiting for the accounts and the budget. Now, if you have any queries about the reports, please forward it either to me or to Sunita, the PCC secretary, honorary secretary. If there are accounts concerning the accounts, please forward those queries, email or phone call or whatever it is, to Mr. Gunaraja, who was the previous treasurer. So he has prepared the accounts, sent it for auditing, so it should be out, I hope, God willing, by next week. So we should be sending out all this by next week. And those who have any questions about budget, please raise your queries or questions with Lukenzi, our new treasurer who is preparing the budget. So these are some of the protocols that needs to be observed. And kindly take note that on the date of AGM, following the service on 9th August, we shall not be entertaining these questions. Rather, just proceed to move on to receive the reports and the accounts and the budget. So the AGM reports and notice of AGM will be given out both by post and electronically by next week. So kindly take note. Together with it, the secretary, the honorary secretary, will also send the voting slip for post in the PCC. Now, kindly take note that there are 2 sets of votes. One is the 8 sitting members for the PCC, as well as the people's forum. This should be voted. I shall be appointing the vicar's ward on the day of AGM. And the presidents and chairmen of the various auxiliary bodies like Women's Fellowship, Golden Circle, and all the stuff will remain as usual until the next AGM. So kindly take note that the voting slip will be sent to you either by electronically or by post, and you must return it to me at least 5 days, I think safer 1 week before the date of the AGM. Now, on the date of the AGM, I will open the votes to be counted by some scrutineers, observers, in view of all of you. So like I said earlier, only 30 people allowed to meet in the church. The rest can meet on Zoom and other media means. So kindly take note that the queries on the AGM report accounts must be in written form, and to reach me or the relevant people, by Mr. Gunaraja, Sunita and Lukenzi, at least 5 days before the date of the AGM. So the person in charge of the respective portfolios will reply by post or electronically after receiving the queries. Now, this is the first time we're doing it this way, so there will be hiccups. Please bear with us, and be patient. Please be patient. Okay? That's my appeal to you. So please look out in the post electronically on all these documents that we send to you. Now, it is a common thing that people say they didn't receive this and didn't receive that. That's the reason why I'm making this announcement. If you don't receive it by the end of June, the beginning of July, then please call me and we will do the needful. Because I don't want to hear on the date of AGM excuses, lame excuses, like I didn't open the WhatsApp, I didn't see it on WhatsApp and all this stuff. So please take this seriously. It will be sent to you and you are responsible for opening and downloading those documents. Thank you. God bless you and pray for a smooth proceeding of our AGM. God bless. Cheers. Sorry about this, but I forgot one more announcement. That is with regards to the election. Kindly take note that those whom you're nominating, you must get their consent. That means it must be signed by them, the nominee for the PCC or People's Warden. And it must be sent by, must be signed also by the proposer and the seconder with your names. So please take note of that. Thank you.